summarize, what is this plan that you've discerned?
Well, at first, let me bring you one of the books here, The Secret Doctrine in Israel by Waite, W-A-I-T-E. This is a book.
We can put this on the screen. Right. There it is right there. That's the book, and Secret Doctrine in Israel, A.E. Waite. And
yes.
I think it was written in 1905, something like that.
Yes, and what it explains is the basically secret doctrine of the Zohar. What is behind Zohar? And you have to understand that the soul of the Talmud is Zohar, and the soul of Zohar is Kabbalah, the occultism or sorcery, as I refer to it. Now, this particular book, it doesn't speak against it. It only explains what it is, what the secret doctrine is. Mm-hmm. And here in the preface, it actually speaks of the secret tradition in Israel, together with some account of the manner in which it influenced Christian scholarship in Europe during 16th, 17th, and 18th centuries. It seems like this is a plot that is not new. This has been pre-planned long time ago.
They've been infiltrating Christian churches and universities and organizations for centuries.
Exactly.
To change the gospel.
To change the gospel and completely put a virus in Christianity. I call that a virus, you know, leaven of the Pharisees. Mm-hmm. And today's Christianity, especially here in America, has a virus. And we have to identify what the virus is. But it's basically the same problem as Apostle Paul has. It's a Judaizing of Christianity. But they also brought in occultic practices. But anyway, as far as I was studying this, I came to a really shocking information. And here on this page, I highlighted it. So let me go back to
it. You know, I want to say that when Jana and Steve told me about the book that we just saw written by Mr. Waite, so while they were talking to me about it, I went online and I found an original first edition from, I think, 1905 or so, and I found one for sale. Because you can buy them reprints,
right?
But I prefer to, whenever I can buy an original first edition, I prefer to do that, because now I can prove to people this is not an alteration. This is the actual first edition of that book. It's like the Scofield Bible. I have several editions, but I have the original first edition. All right, which was, I think, 1907, something like that, when the very first one came out. Because I want to be able to prove to people the lies that Cyrus Scofield published in the Holy Bible. And if you have the actual first edition, that's proof, that's evidence. Nobody can say, well, the copy you have is 100 years old, it's been changed, it's been altered. No. I want to be able to hold that first one. So I was able today to order an original first year, you know, edition of this book.
Right.
And I'm very eager to study this book. So what's in this book? What am I going to find?
Well, you're going to find what is actual secret doctrine of the Zohar. It's not pretty. I don't really recommend that people who are not strong in faith or it's a book for the research. For the purpose of researching what the doctrine of actual Kabbalah, Zohar, and Talmud is, what Judaism is about, because once you understand what Judaism is about, you start understanding that these bridges that Christian ministers are making with Pharisees or rabbis today, those are very dangerous bridges.
Yes.
And on one side, you know, it's always Christians that submit to the Jews. It's always Christians that have to agree not to preach Jesus to Jews. You see, the Jews, they don't compromise. They will never compromise what they believe. But the Christians are ready to compromise. And why? Because they have wolves for teachers.
Yeah.
who have actually made bridges with the Pharisees, the enemy of Christ. But in this particular book, I just want to read you a little bit what got me understanding what the plot is against Christianity. It says here, according to the Midrash Talpigoth, the Messiah will bring eternal peace, which of course was understood by the Israelites as peace for Israel, plus that which may follow extermination for all who did not enter by conversion into the house of Jacob.
So extermination.
Yes. So basically what they teach is that if Gentiles or Christians do not attach themselves to the Jews, they will be exterminated. And of course, we are well known for our Noahide laws, that we brought this to a light. So then you go to Talmud and you start reading what is the plan for Gentiles. You see, Judaism is a two-tier system. Judaism puts the wall of partition back. It's the Jews and non-Jews. And according to Judaism, non-Jews are different species. They are not, they're humans, but they're not at a level of the Jews. Jews are supposedly divine. They're the light of the world. They're the chosen. They have life of Hashem inside of them. That's the way they explain it, life of God inside. And the Gentiles, they can never achieve it. They're different species. They're on animalistic level. And the only way for Gentiles to make it to the world to come is to attach themselves to the Jews. And how do they do that? Well, through the Noahide laws, seven Noahide laws.
What percentage of Jews in the world believe that trash?
Well, this is an interesting question.